Yes, we're on Instagram. Say goodnight to everybody.
Good night. We are children. We are the ones who make a brighter day. So let's start giving.
Good job. That was beautiful. Thanks for singing for us, and everybody loves how you sang there as well. You see the comments. People are saying she's so pretty and talented. Priya is saying thank you, Coryn. What are you saying? People tell you sing nice.
Thank you.
All right. So we're going to say good night to everybody now. Good night, guys. Thanks for tuning
good
in.
Good night.
And welcome back, everyone, to Read2Me TT Bedtime Series. Hope you all are ready for another fun bedtime story. My name is Dionne Baptiste-Clarke, and I'm here with...
Coryn Anaya Clarke.
And how old are you, Coryn?
4.
You're 4? When are you going to be 5?
When is my birthday?
When is your birthday?
October 23rd.
October 23rd. Are you excited for your birthday?
Yes.
Yes? Why are you excited?
Because...
What are you looking for? What do you want for your birthday? You don't know yet? Alright, that's okay. You'll think about it, right?
Okay.
Okay, do you... Okay, you want to do this part? Or do you want me to do it?
Me.
Okay.
Okay, kids. So we all know the past few weeks have had us inside. But just to remember, we are all being heroes in our own way by staying inside and flattening the curve. So tonight we have a great story all about grannies. Do you want to tell us about this book?
Okay, so the name of the book is what?
Is That My Granny?
And it's written and illustrated by Janilyn James. Let's get started. Are you excited to read the story?
Yes, yes.
Yeah? I'm excited to hear you read it.
Daddy, can we have the key?
Nice and loud, okay? So everybody could hear you.
My granny lived alone in a house in the Diamond Vale, Legal Martin. She's big and tall and very strong. My granny grows fruit in the backyard and she loves to take care of her plants. Granny hugged me when we went to visit her. She gave me sponge cake to eat, oopsie, and orange juice to drink. Granny always gives me a big hug and a kiss on my cheeks.
Can I read this part? You want to read it?
One day, Granny pinched me and showed me an ugly face. The next time I went to visit, she screamed at me and told me to tell Toppin. Granny's meaning what has happened to my granny. After that, Granny got sick and we went to see her in the hospital. My mother said that Granny will have to stay in another home. Granny needed people to help her all the time.
Can I ask a question before you continue, Coryn?
Okay.
Why does Granny need people to take care of her?
Because she's sick.
She's sick? Okay, so let's go continue to read to find out what Granny's sick with. So long a little bit, right?
Okay.
So everybody can understand. Go ahead.
We helped Granny pack her clothes. She went to live in a home with many other grannies and grandpas. Soon after that, we went to visit her in the big new home. Nurses walked around the big home feeding and helping all the granny and grandpa. Granny smiled when she saw us, but she forgot my name. Is that my granny? I asked my mother. She has Alzheimer's disease. What? That's a really big word. I don't know how to spell that, I said. When people have Alzheimer's disease, they sometimes forget your name, my mother said.
Can I read now? Or are you reading all?
I'm reading all.
Okay, go ahead.
What's it?
People are saying hi, Coryn, from Alyssa. Alyssa is looking on. So go ahead and read.
Okay. A long time after, we brought Granny to our home, to our house, to eat Christmas dinner with us. Granny cannot walk. Now she has to sit in a wheelchair and we put her around. Granny says the same thing over and over. She called me Wallace and smiled. That's not my name, Granny. That's your brother's name. Is that my granny? I asked. She has Alzheimer's disease, and it will get worse, said Mommy. Can't, it can get worse. That sounds scary, I said.
What is Granny sick with?
Alzheimer's disease.
Alzheimer's disease? And what happens when you have Alzheimer's disease?
People sometimes forget your names.
Oh, so Granny forgot his name. Mm-hmm. Okay, go ahead.
After some months...
Slow down just a little bit, right?
After some months, we visited Granny again, but she could not get out of bed. She lay on the bed looking at us with sad eyes. The nurse had to feed her. She can't even go to the toilet. Granny wears big diapers like a baby. The nurse has to change her diaper. Is that my granny? I asked. She is in the last stage of Alzheimer's disease, my mother said. Granny's just like a baby. She needs lots of help. I felt very sad for my granny. I gave her a big hug. Do you want to ask me a question?
Okay, you want me to ask you a question? Mm-hmm. Okay, so tell me again what sickness Granny has. What's the name of the disease that Granny has?
Alzheimer's disease.
Alzheimer's disease? Mm-hmm. Would you feel sad if your granny got sick? If your grandma and mama Jen got sick? Mm-hmm. You wouldn't feel sad?
No.
Of course you feel sad if grandma and mama Jen got sick. Okay, go ahead and read.
Not long after, my parents took me to the hospital. Granny was lying on the bed with her eyes closed. She could not speak and could not move. We had many tubes attached to her. Granny is really sick and she won't be with us much longer, said Dad. Do you want to tell her goodbye? But she can't hear me, I said. That's okay, Daddy. She will know you were here. I said goodbye to Granny. I kissed her on her cheek. I hope she heard me.
Okay, so what's happening with Granny on this page?
On this page?
Yeah, what's happening with Granny?
Granny could not move or could not speak. She had tubes attached to her.
She had tubes attached to her?
Mm-hmm.
So that means she's getting even sicker?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
I saw Granny after that at the big tube. She was dressed up and looked like she was asleep lying in a box. What box is this? I asked my. It's called a coven, she said. Granny is asleep forever. We all send for Granny. Oopsie. Auntie, uncle, cousin, and friends came to say goodbye. Everyone cried, but I didn't cry because Mommy said Granny is in a better place. Bye-bye, Granny. We love you. And that's the end of the story, everyone.
That's the end of the story. But could you summarize the story for me? Tell me what happened. What was the story about?
Okay, the story was about Granny didn't remember the boy's name.
Okay, why didn't Granny remember his name?
Because she had Alzheimer's disease.
She had Alzheimer's disease.
Mm-hmm.
And what happened?
What happened?
Mm-hmm. When she got Alzheimer's disease.
Granny got this. She could not move or could not speak. She had tubes attached to her.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and what did Granny do with the boy before she got sick? Do you remember?
Yes.
What did she do?
I think she was giving her sponge cake to eat and orange juice to drink.
Do you like sponge cake?
Yes.
And what's your favorite flavor juice?
Fruit punch.
You like fruit punch?
Yes.
I like orange juice.
I like apple and fruit punch.
Okay. What else do you remember about the story?
She was in the big church,
mm-hmm.
and she was asleep. And then she was in a box called the coffin.
Mm-hmm.
And then aunties, uncles, cousins, and friends come to say goodbye.
Yes. And did the little boy cry?
No.
He didn't cry. Why didn't he cry?
Because Granny is in a better place.
Okay. Do you like this story? I enjoyed this story.
Mm-hmm.
I like the way you read the story as well.
But Mommy, is that the end?
Well, that's the end of the story. You want to talk some more?
Mm-hmm.
What do you want to say?
I want to talk.
Oh, you want to read the comments. Okay, so let me tell you what some Uncle Ray is. The Uncle Ray said, bravo. Then we have somebody saying, great job. Look, Priya is saying, look how she summarized this story. Very easy. Priya is asking if you could sing again. You want to sing again?
Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah?
I can sing again.
Okay,
everyone.
They want to hear you sing again. So you can talk to them by the time.
Okay.
Say goodnight, guys.
Good night.
What else do you want to tell them?
I'm going to show them.
What do you want to show them, Coryn? Okay, so we're going to find the song.
Everyone that's not the song.
Wait, I'm not picking up this YouTube now.
Everyone that's not the song.
Okay, so this book, Coryn, tonight we read for the children as part of Read2Me TT Bedtime Stories. And just to remind everyone, this story was called, what was the name of the story?
It's That My Granny.
And it was written and illustrated by Janelyn James. Where are you going? You're going to sing for them, Dad. You're going to play the song.
What's so properly. They want to read one more book for them.
What book you want to read?
Go
get one of your small ones quickly. Yeah, she does. She's not ready. She's not ready to stop yet. So she's going to get one of her small books to read. I hope that's okay. Quickly. You get me some?
Let us realize to meet the bride that is always dragging.
Good job. Good job. So we have one more thing to say. Thanks again, guys, for joining us for Read2Me TT's nightly bedtime series. Hope you had fun reading with us.
Yeah. But before we go, it's really important that you listen to us. Are you listening? Do you want to be...
Nice or no?
Do you want to be little... washed?
Superheroes?
Here is what you can do to help. Wash your hands with soap and sing happy birthday twice. So you will know...
Point?
No, point.
Mm-hmm. So you will know you've...
washed it long enough. Keep your hands out of your mouth and remind mommy, daddy, granny, everyone to wear their masks. They are going out.
We can do this. Why? Because we are in this together.
See you tomorrow, kiddies, for a brand new story with two new readers.
Thanks for watching. Good night.
Good night, everybody.